I was your typical high school student that really didn't know what they wanted to do. You know, senior year rolled around and it was like, man, I better figure something out. You know, college is approaching quickly. I knew that I wanted to work in the healthcare field. You know, I just really like working with people.
Hello. Mark, how's it going?
I'm Matt. I'm a PA student that's working here at the Urdy Center. Is it okay if I talk with you for a little bit?
Yes.
Okay, sounds good.
I've always been someone that likes building relationships and connecting with people. And working as a PA, I have that privilege and the honor of working with people on a daily basis. I get to build relationships, establish rapport, things like that. With what I had done through my research about physician assistants, certainly seemed like it'd be a good choice. It's a rapidly growing field. It's a field where you can make a decent salary, a decent living, and it just really, it just feels right for me. Also, you know, with being a PA, you're always challenged. Science and medicine, it's a very challenging field. There's a ton of information out there. And I feel that that's important to challenge yourself on a daily basis. A lot of people don't actually know what a PA is. It's actually a healthcare provider that has a lot of responsibility and is able to do a lot in the medical field. And they practice medicine under the guidance of a supervising physician.
I was talking to a 9-year-old named Sakaya. She came in, she's complaining of some left eye, sort of itching, pink eye. It's been going on for 2 years.
The program itself requires 2 years of prerequisite work. Then you have to get a certain amount of medical exposure hours. So those would be the first 2 years, is just getting all that prerequisite stuff done and getting your interview, getting accepted in the program. Once you're in the program, you have the junior year, which consists of just a lot of in-class work as well as lab work and work in the cadaver lab. It's 3 semesters, high credit loads and long hours and a lot of studying, but it's certainly worth it. You learn a lot during that junior year, which certainly helps you in your senior year during your clinical rotations. Important to sort of integrate what you see clinically as well as with the book work, because what you do in the book isn't necessarily what you're going to be doing, you know, in the clinic. And it's important to sort of make those connections.
It's in the back of your knee?
It feels like a trolley horse.
The senior year is 9 clinical rotations. You have family practice, pediatrics, internal medicine, OBGYN, psychiatry, surgery, emergency medicine, primary care, and you also get to choose an elective. You can choose a specialty that you like and go spend a month there, see if that's what you actually like, if you're not interested in one of the other areas. I'm very grateful for the education that Penn College has provided for me. They have given me a very strong foundation in medicine, and it's something that I'm going to have for the rest of my life. I'm going to be taking care of patients, and the core of what I do is coming from Penn College, and I'm forever thankful for that.